So similarly, we were working on the column also, right? So what we are trying, we are taking one blank list of columns here, blank list, right? In which we will store all the values which are already filled in the column. Okay, so that we can compare it with the guess. Okay, so for I in the range, you know that there are total 9 rows, right? And for every row, you have to check the value for the column. So here, if I talk about that this is the column, so what will be the value of column? The value of the column will be 8, right? So if I want to check all the values in this column, right? How I can check? What are the values in this column? How I can check? To check the values in this column 8, every time, what will be the value of column? Column's value will remain 8, right? But the row's value will change. If I want to check what will be here, so it will be 8 column and row 0. Next time, if I want to check this one, it will be 8 column and row 1. Here, column's value is again 8. Yeah, it is in the 8th column, and what will be the row? 2. Although value is different. So next is 8th column and which row? 3 row, right? Then this will be again 8th column and 4th row, 5th row, 6th row, and so on. So column is always 8 and the rows values, they keep on changing. So this is how it is working. So the rows are always changing. So that's why for I in range 9. So it means rows value go from 0 to 8. Okay. And for that value, what we are doing, this call underscore val, this empty list of columns that we have created, we are appending what? We are adding it to it. All the elements that are at that particular row, for example, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 row, and the column is always suppose 8. So we are filling all the values in it. So you write these three statements or you write this single statement, everything is same. Okay. Then after filling all the values in call underscore vals, which values which are already present, we are checking if guess is in these values. If it is in these values, we are not interested. So we are returning false. It means that guess we are not interested in. So now we have checked the validity of rows. If it is not valid, so we are returning false. Even if in the column, if it is not valid, we are returning false. Now we have to work on that square also, 3x3 square also. Okay. So that's why it is written and then the square. Now after row, after column, our focus is on the square. Okay. So suppose I am interested, the blank space, the blank empty space provided to me is suppose this one. After I running the find next empty, okay, space function. So this is the empty space returned to me. Okay. So what is the row? What is the column? It will be in the second row. This is 0. This is 1. This is second row. And what is the column? Column is 0 and 1. So suppose this is the empty space returned to me that I have to fill. Okay. So if I fill it, if I have to fill it, so I can start with, what will be the first value you will fill? You will fill first. You will fill 1. After filling 1, you will keep on checking, is it valid or not? To check if it is valid or not, suppose to check that if 1, if I am filling here is valid or not, then we have to check all the values. What are the other values in that row? There is 9, there is 6, there is 1, there is 4. So these are the row values that I got. I'm explaining. So these are the row values I got. This is my guess. And I see that my guess is in it. 1 is my guess, but it is already present. It means I should put it. Okay. After that, it means then I will check for 2. Okay, I will check for this row also and for this column also. And then I have to check for this square also, that 1 should not be present in this square also. 2 should not be present in this square also. 3 should not be present in this square also if I am filling it here. Okay. Now to check the square, you know that this is the first square. This is the first square. This is the second square. This is the third square. Okay. So suppose this is the empty space provided to me. This is the empty space. So I try to fill 7 in it. Sorry. My guess is 7. Then I will check. Okay. 7 is not present in it. 7 is also not present in it. Now what next I have to check? I have to check that 7 should not also be present in this square. Okay, for this 3x3 square, from where it is starting? It is starting from here. Which row? 0, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th row. Okay, and where it is ending? It is ending at the 8th row. Okay, so let me take you back here. So now we are working on the square. So from where it is starting, row underscore start, what it is given? Row, and then there is a flow, division operator 3 multiply by 3. Okay, so here it is given that if you give fifth row, then fifth divide by 3, it will be 1, and 1 multiply by 3 is 3. Okay, why it is telling me that this is a fifth row? If I'm in the fifth row, how we can check? The row will be started by whatever row is given to you, or the same row will be you flow divided with 3 multiply by 3. Similarly, column will be the whatever column, the empty column that you have given. You have to divide it by 3, multiply by 3. Now that will be your row start and column start. Okay. For R in range, now whatever row start you have given and you are doing row start plus 3, how your square will become? So suppose So this is a square, right? So suppose I am here. So this is the row start that I got. So if I am working on the small square, what it will be? This row start plus 3. Similarly, this column plus 3, that will be my square of interest, right? Similarly, the same thing is given here, that for R in range, row start to row start plus 3, column from column start plus 3, we will check. Now we are working on the square. So if puzzles R and C, the current R and C is equals to guess, even in that range you have the guess, you will return the false. Right? So let me run this code and show you how it works. So this is a blank. Can you see when I am running it, the whole spaces are filled already. Okay. So previously 3 and 9 was there. After that, there were 2 blank spaces, minus 1 and minus 1. But now all the blank spaces are also filled. Okay, so you can try this on your side and see if it also works for you. I will send and share this with you. And I hope that you have got some understanding of this code. So with that, I am going to end this class. So stay tuned for more lab work. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.